As a motor, the DC machine is most suited to driving a load when it is required to control the speed of the load, for example, in lifting and traction machinery. Likewise, as a generator, the machine will produce a direct current output depending on its speed and excitation. In its most basic form, a DC machine consists of the following key parts, namely a rotating part called the armature, a stationary part called the stator, which contains the yoke, the poles, and field windings, two end shields fitted with bearings which support the armature, and a set of brushes held in position by brush holders, collectively called brush rigging. Let's discuss the construction and function of each of these parts in detail. We begin with the armature. A typical armature incorporates the following components, namely a core comprising a number of sheets of high-grade electrical steel called laminations, which are pressed onto a steel shaft. Next, the armature windings, which consist of a number of evenly distributed coils of copper wire which are wound into the slots in the core. The ends of the armature coils are connected to the commutator, which is attached to the end of the shaft. The commutator consists of a number of copper bars or segments, which are insulated from each other and the shaft. Next, the brush rigging. On all DC motors or generators, current must be conducted to or from the armature windings via the commutator.